Right, here we go then. Round 10, reverse grid. Last race at Spa this weekend. Mid-pack. Oh, Brody stole second. Alright. That little group does for a second. I'm just going to stay back for a sec. I'll get caught up in this drama because there's going to be some drama there big time. I obviously don't want to be left behind here. So we can drum back. Oh my days. I get hit by power. That nudge then, I wasn't hitting it.
Thank you.
let go of that then. If I carried on going in my line, I would have took his back end out. It's a bit unfortunate, but at least it pulled out. right there. So much quicker through there than Mark. As you can definitely change that to 6, which is not what we want to be doing there. And we're going to stop the time, move complete, let's go. Right, on to the next one, 5th place. Thank you. case, we need a full tank. What have we got? Oh, we don't need a full tank. Seems like this game's lying to us again as normal. We're gonna go right up, just under, because we've got 2 minutes under. If we need to save a little bit of fuel, we will. Back up. This is in a really, really good position. Get up. It's on those cold tires. Welcome back, Ben. Right, back into sixth. Everyone in the pit's done now, I believe. It's not the best of racing this weekend for me, to be fair. Mediotic sort of finishes sixth. And wherever we are, going to finish on this one. I can definitely tell I haven't raced. Also got took out, which I'm going to have to speak to the leader of the UOL. Second time I've been done by that person. I mean, if I take someone out by accident, I normally give them the position back, and there was no attempt to do that. So he got took out in front of me, like two laps prior to that by someone else. But as he spun, he would have seen just me there. So I reckon he thinks it was me and just completely just ran us off the road. But yeah, so we'll get that sorted out after this. How are you doing? fully understand accidents happen, but, you know, own up to them. Slow down, give the position back. That's the rules, that's what we've all been told. I mean, I do that regardless, even if I'm in, you know, daily races. It's cursing. Yeah, I'm good, dude. I'm good. Struggling after a week off. Proper struggling after a week off, mate. Looking forward for a bit of Forza tomorrow, boys. Should be on. Nice. What time are you looking at getting on, dude? Should be on about midday. Might get on at 11. We had such a good weekend last weekend at that time. I've not really had much time to do anything new then, so I've had YouTube video for about 3 days, so I had to bung up 3 today. I've been so busy this week. So I took little one out shopping, just got a new push bike. And obviously I've been doing all this in here. So spending a bit of family time here and there as well, spent a little bit of time with a friend. I mean, I say a little bit of time, we went to Exeter to pick up stuff for the street group, but also chilled with him for a little bit. And then obviously I've been out on the bike today. See the bike pictures in my Instagram story. Mate, that camera just makes it look so much better, you know what I mean? What a cracking lens on it. Now, I was speaking to someone that used to own my bike. About 4 years ago, he opened my bike. So, 3 years ago, sorry. How weird's that? All the people are seeing is that guy. Yeah, he got across me. Without his, he would never have seen the number plate. He wouldn't have seen the number plate. And he's like, yo, has that got blah, blah, blah on the end? I was like, yeah, that's the one. He's like, man, I used to own that bike. I ran out of fuel today though, Ben, so my friend had to come pick me up with some petrol. My fuel gauge works, but I was having so much fun on the bike, I forgot to have a little look. And because it's a sports bike, I actually am, you know, bent over quite a bit, but my visor on the bike, the windshield, covers half the clocks and dials. So the light is up in the top light, which actually covered. Unless I'm leaning right down and actually look down in there, I wouldn't see it. And that's exactly what's happened. I noticed it, and I was like, oh, is that only just come on? If that's only just come on, I could easily make home. And it didn't. Probably peak 140. It's not really the sort of road you could do speed. It's like a B road. All single, well, I say single, you know, one each side. Yeah, no, I just went to the beach, but I didn't even get off at the beach. I just parked up on the side of the road and took a few photos. Chilled on my phone for maybe 5 minutes, come back on and rode back. But I've just got it insured today. You know, when we went into lockdown, I wasn't insured. I ended my insurance there. There's no point paying for a policy that you're not going to use. You're in lockdown, so it's been parked up outside. I just fucking put the insurance on it. It's like my first ride this year. Let's go. For another year now. As you pulled out your head. Yeah, man, lovely day for today though. I used to put full levers on, you know what I mean? Just because I haven't been out on the bike for so long. It's like my racing boots, racing, you know, racing suit, everything on. Boom. It's going to be the final lap then, guys, by the look of it. 35 seconds left, they're already, you know, halfway around there, so definitely not going to have another lap in us. Obviously I have proper racing gloves for my butt. these, I don't know what these are actually for. I'm pretty sure they're for a sim for this. I think they're actually built for this purpose. But I'm not sure. I think these are sim racing gloves. Expensive though, for what they are, you know what I mean? For what they are, they're freaking expensive. But I tell you what, they're definitely worth it. I mean, right now, I'm like, must be about 100 degrees in this room. It is so hot. I can feel my hands would have been sweating. I think it was about £24. £24, but when you think about what they actually are, and you can buy a normal pair of gloves for like, you know, £4, you kind of feel like maybe I've been ripped off a little bit for these. I like them, they're red, they're mad comfy, they grip the wheel real good, I mean that's what matters. Look at that, so cutting our fuel off a little bit early, which is so not listening to the game. Right, round 10 of the Porsche, guys, come 7th. Round 9, we came 6th. So not a great weekend, but after a week off from racing and not touching anything, plus without making too many excuses, with the Forza wheel settings that we've been used to all week, that, well, prior to before going on this, I think we did quite well, to be fair. We did quite well. But yeah, let's call it there. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love me, even if it's fake.